Janet, what are you, joking? Well, darling, Janet's an unusual woman. I mean, do you know she's actually a dancer?
Well, she's very attractive.
Well, yes, I know. Well, yes, yes, she is. But not to me, you see, darling. Not to me, darling.
A little overheated, though, by her sweetheart.
Darling, what in the world are you saying?
Darling, you seem a bit tight, a bit high.
Listen, are you kidding? Believe me, I'm in very good shape. And you're not in such bad shape yourself, you know, darling. I mean, fuck Janet, you're looking very attractive. Very, very attractive, darling. I'm really not kidding. I mean, your hair, darling. And that marvelous lipstick.
Well, Bruce.
No, darling, really, I'm really being serious. The people at this party are very excited by you, darling. I mean, these people would really like to have you, darling. They'd really like to have you. They really want you, if you get my meaning.
Darling, I think you're a little bit insane tonight, dear. A little drunk, a little absurd.
Darling, your hands look awfully cold. Why is that?
I really don't know.
Are you sick?
I don't think so.
Listen to me, darling. You don't think it's possible.
Am I sick? Cancer? What for? Some serious illness?
No, darling, I was referring to the flu. But I mean, I'm sure you're all right. You just look a bit peaked. You need another drink now, darling.
What? Well, you see, I've worked my ass off. I mean, I've really worked my ass off for the guy. I mean, for 3 whole years with no credit for myself, with no respect being paid to myself. And I've just sat there quietly and listened to people talk about him and praise him and say how great he is. And that's fine. That's wonderful. But the problem happens to be that the guy is driving me bananas. I mean, the guy is insane. I mean, he keeps coming into my office and just poking at my desk and sort of saying, well, Ellen, how are things? And it's really just driving me bananas to the point where I really don't know what to do. Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah. Sure. Excuse me. Excuse me. Let me get this part straight in my head before we go any further, all right? I mean, you seem to be saying that children don't need to learn to read. I mean, isn't that really your point? Isn't that what you're saying?
No.
Well, here you are, darling. Here's that ring. And here's one for me. Good Christ, I like these. But are you all right, darling? Are you feeling a bit better? You look great, darling. Just great. Great. So, why don't you tell me? Be frank with me, darling. Do you care for me at all? Do you actually love me? That's very exciting. I like that, darling. I really do like it. Only you should fuck me more often than darling if you find me so handsome.
Oh, please, really?
No, really, you should shoot me more often. I mean, because you can be sort of a frigid bitch at certain times, darling. Well, of course, I'm being an asshole. I know that, darling. I mean, some people aren't, but I just happen to be one somehow. An asshole, I mean.
Bruce. Really?
But I need another drink. I mean, I really do like these drinks here tonight. They're just extremely decently prepared. I'll bet you'd like one as well, now wouldn't you? I'll bet you would.
No, I really didn't say that children don't need to learn to read, you see. I just said that there will soon be machines on the market that will be capable of reading books aloud.
Yes, that's just great.
Yes, it seems to me we're talking about a world without any books at all.
No books of any kind! I mean, isn't that what the whole situation comes to, really?
Well, some books might appear on certain forms of tape that a machine can more easily read.
Yes, I see.
And then, I know this is funny, but actually the most difficult part is that I can't help liking the guy in a way. I'm actually quite fond of him as a person, you see, but it's just so hard to deal with a guy like that on a day-to-day basis because you don't want to hurt the guy's feelings. But on the other hand, you really want to do certain things that would probably really hurt him.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I understand what you're saying, but I mean, isn't it possible for people just to sometimes not feel what they actually do feel?
What?
I mean, they may feel a certain thing, but they don't really know that they do because in their own conscious minds, they're so incredibly involved in what they think that they feel that they really don't feel the thing at all. Do you know what I mean? I mean, sometimes a person might think that they ought to be feeling some kind of affection for some person, and so they think that they feel it, but actually what they feel is something completely different.
You mean?
I mean, like, a very common example is when a person is supposed to feel pleased by something, like when someone gives you a present and you're supposed to feel pleased. not supposed to say, well, I really hate this. You're supposed to say, oh boy, that's great, I really like it. So then actually you know that you don't actually feel pleased, but you don't want to hurt the person's feelings, particularly if there's someone you like and they try to get you something you'd enjoy. I mean, there's sometimes a difference because sometimes the person is giving you something that unconsciously they know you'll hate, but sometimes they just really think you'll like it, but for some particular reason, it just happens to turn out that you actually don't.
I really don't know what you mean, Bettina.
Well, here's that drink now, my love.
Thank you, Bruce. I really feel sick.
Well, you can just rest right here. You can even fall asleep. No one's going to disturb you.
Some people don't have a lot of money, you know, Tim.
Well, Jean, I know.
Somebody can't afford to buy a piano. Did you ever think of that? Some people can't afford to buy a guitar. They can't have musical soirees. They can't sing madrigals in the evenings. Did you ever think of that? Maybe they're just a little bit too tired from working. Maybe they're just a little bit too hungry, if that's not too embarrassing to say. Oh, now she's really exaggerating. Too hungry. How absurd. Well, it may not be so absurd, as a matter of fact.
And obviously, I'm not saying I know the whole story. I've read certain articles.
You've written.
I said I've read certain articles. I've talked to some of the people who know more than I do, and the fact happens to be that I just happen to be there when some of the things that I've read about just happen to be occurring.
Listen! There are babies out there who are dying because they were brought up on milk intentionally mislabeled. I mean, milk that was mixed with water. There are old men and old women, and they can't afford to buy underwear. They need all the money that they have just to survive and pay the rent. Maybe they'd like to sing madrigals, but they don't have anything to wear.
I mean, I saw that man being pressed between two panes of glass, and it was horrible. The way his tongue was hanging to one side, he looked like a slaughtered beast.
But why are you telling me this?
I said that these are the articles. Don't you see? That's what I was trying to say.
I really don't feel like talking about this. I really don't want to.
Well, darling, I'm glad you're waking up. You had me worried for a while. I was just having a conversation with some people over there, and you know, there are some interesting things about the treatment of certain illnesses that Jack was explaining to me. Do you know, there was a time when vomiting was induced in patients whom today we would classify as mentally ill.
Bruce, did you slap me while I was sleeping?
Why, of course not, darling. What do you mean? Are you crazy?
I don't feel normal.
God. Darling, you don't think you might be mentally ill now, do you? I mean, darling, you don't think you might be crazy, do you?
Just talk to me, Bruce.
I've had this terrible feeling that something was about to happen to you.
Just talk to me, Bruce. Help me. Hold me.
Anyway, I'm going over by the bar again, darling. I'll get you another drink. Meanwhile, you just keep resting. I've got to have a word with Grace over there.
With who, Bruce?
You remember her, darling? That friend of Chuck? That brunette? The one who went fishing in her panties.
What?
Actually, I spent the night with her once about 11 years ago. I'll tell you, she was really amazing. I'll never forget.
Darling, I'm sick.
Darling, why is it that whenever we have a conversation, you always feel sick? Have you ever really noticed that? It's really a pattern with you. It's sort of upsetting. And it actually gives me a pain in the ass, if you really want to know.
All right, Bruce.
And I mean, really, darling, the expressions you get on your face sometimes. I mean, these people are going to think you're an absolute nut.
All right, Bruce, I said all right, all right.
I love you, Marie.
I love you too, Bruce.